Okay, so let's look at the our frequency samples again and get a understanding here how these negative frequencies are how these negative frequencies can be understood. And so here we've got n half, and so this corresponds to fs half, our sampling half of our sampling rate, so Nyquist rate. Here the first sample was DC, and then essentially from here to here we're having increasing frequencies. Increasing frequencies depending on the index number. And now from here to the very end, to n minus 1, we have again decreasing frequencies. So let's see our x of k. And so how can we understand that? Let's have a first look here on that side. And remember that this index k here, this creates a phasor, so a moving complex vector, which is looking like that. So depending on the k, this rotation becomes faster and faster. So if we remember, for low frequencies it goes only round once. So that's our real part, that's our imaginary part, and we can imagine, depending on the k, this phasor from here jumps to that point, then to that, then to that, then to that. So it rotates around here. And so, and this gives us these positive frequencies. What we have seen. So now here on this side, something interesting is happening. So remember, in the middle here we had this condition that we've got only these two points here. This happened at fs half. So now here at this point the k is getting higher. So what we're getting here, for example, is something like that. So we are jumping more than 180 degrees. More than 180 degrees. But this can be also obviously interpreted the way that we're rotating the other way around, so that we're doing this here. So that we have something like 360 degrees minus this angle alpha here, what we have here. And so, and therefore we could see this as a rotation which is going the other way around. And this we interpret as negative frequencies. So essentially here the rotation is clock counterwise. And here the rotation can be interpreted as clockwise. So with that, we have established how our frequency vector is created, and that we have n different frequencies.